Several locations were considered for the B reactor, but Hanford quickly floated to the top of the list because a river ran past it.
That's why the site was chosen, because of this immense quantity of clean water from the Columbia River. The site had to have a large supply of water because they were going to use the water to cool the reactor. And then the Columbia River also was generating power at two new dams, Cooley upstream and Bonneville downstream from Hanford.
Even the clear water of the Columbia needed additional filtering, since the tiniest particles could build up over time or become radioactive as they passed through the reactor. Equally as important as the purity of the water going into the reactor was the quality of the water being returned to the Columbia, as documented in newsreels of the day.
At Hanford, biologists study the effects of radioactivity on fish, since Columbia River water is pumped through the plant. To safeguard Washington's flourishing fish industry, 25,000 trout and salmon are hatched each year and exposed to water contaminated with radioactivity. This is only one example of precautions that go on endlessly. In this case, there is not enough radioactivity to harm the fish or persons eating them.
The groundbreaking water purification system designed for Hanford by DuPont engineers was so good that it soon became the industry standard for municipal water supplies across the country. Water quality and safety standards at Hanford were so stringent that workers were confident they were safe.
Obviously, we have radiation surrounding us all the time, but the impact on the environment was always very carefully monitored. I always felt extremely safe here.
Once surrounded by dozens of structures and miles of pipe, today the B reactor stands alone. But as a lasting reminder, a river still runs past it.